Welcome to the Agilent EESoft EDA demo amplifier simulation with Smart Simulation Wizard. In today's agenda, we'll provide an overview of the Smart Simulation Wizard. We'll demonstrate the simulation setup using the wizard and an example circuit. We'll also demonstrate the simulation process and review the data results. The benefit of Smart Simulation Wizard is fast simulation results. You can finish your simulation quickly, and analysis is made easy for new or infrequent users of EDA tools. Simulations are automatically set up by selecting the test that you want. Test results are available in a handy but powerful display environment. Let's now move on to the demonstration. Smart Simulation can be accessed through the Smart Simulation icon. Smart Simulation is application driven, and the user will be prompted to select an application type. This is so Smart Simulation can provide the automation for your application type. In this case, we'll select the amplifier application. The user can import a number of ADS application examples to jumpstart their work, or they can start a whole new amplifier subcircuit. In this case, we'll use a sample amplifier provided with Smart Simulation, and we'll choose the MOSFET power amplifier example. This is the Smart Simulation environment. The design is partitioned between an amplifier subcircuit and a Smart Simulation module. Smart Simulation sets up the sources, simulation controls, and data display templates. You will notice for this application that the RF input, RF output, and bias are pre-wired for your convenience. The user can push down into the subcircuit hierarchy to view or modify the subcircuit contents. In this case, we'll not be modifying the contents, and we will move on to the simulation setup. The user can double-click on the icon to set up the simulation. This is the simulation setup menu. There are two tabs, a simulation selection tab and a simulation settings tab. You will notice that the simulations are predefined into easy to understand tests. The most commonly used tests are grouped for convenience, and combinations of linear and nonlinear tests can be run. To add a test for simulation, I simply select the tests I want to run and select them for simulation. Now that I've selected my tests, I will check my simulation settings. My simulation settings are grouped into an easy-to-understand format. In this case, my settings look good, so I'll now move back to the simulation selection. To simulate, I need to go into the bottom left-hand corner of the menu and click the Simulate button. We are now ready to display our results. To display the results, click on the Display the Results button. The data displays invoked, automatically set up, and automatically generated. There is no intervention required by the user. For associated tests, the data is automatically and conveniently located all on one page. In this case, the maximum available gain, associated power gain, stability factor, and minimum noise figure that I was looking for is all displayed. Data displayed in this fashion can be more convenient than thumbing through multiple windows looking for the data that I want. If generated in separate windows, the tests that I just simulated could populate up to 9 separate windows. Let's now summarize this demonstration. In summary, Smart Simulation Wizard provides an easy way to unleash the power of ADS. It's fast. You can finish your simulation quickly. Analysis is made easy for new or infrequent users of EDA tools. Simulations are automatically set up by selecting the test that you want. And tests are made available in a handy but powerful display environment.